Dreams first, and
we change. So now we do philosophy first.
Well, you do dreams.
But either way.
Oh, okay. Look, is this an important question in terms of the way we were going today and the Parmenides group? And in general, is it not an issue in Parmenides?
Yeah.
I didn't see the relationship between this and, of course, well, in the morning conversation. But there, that's why I'm very intrigued to see where it's going to go. Funny how we were walking up the...
Yeah. Well, it would imply that Lucia...
Pardon me?
I mean, it has an implicates tough motive. Suggests Lucia as being a part of that, if you're self-reflective, or if you're turning upon yourself. Where's the motion to do that? So would it come from outside? It would be seen.
I remember one time, I don't know if this was, I mean, I think this is an example. Like, I remember I had a talk with you once, and I had not gone to work. I had not gone to teaching because I thought, I am so unprepared. It's just a disaster. I'm not going to work. So I had a talk with you. And you asked me how prepared I would have been. And actually, I would have been the most prepared of ever. It was my favorite topic. It was such my favorite topic, I didn't even have to prepare. I was so prepared. And my state of mind was beautiful. It was like ideal. And I called in sick. And that talk left such an impression on me that sometimes I think, oh, I'm going to call in sick, right? And then I have to, like, reflect on that conclusion that I couldn't make, that if you don't think you're prepared,
watch out.
That means you are likely very prepared. So I never call in sick anymore. I haven't called in sick since.
So you're always prepared.
Yeah, I'm always prepared. And so I think that's what see it, but I have to reflect on that whole thing. Whenever I think I'm going to call in sick.
Good. Okay.
Is that Lucia? Is that Lucia?
This question.
Yeah.
The key propositions and the elements of theology is 16 and 17.
What is the relationship?
Okay. So we'll do some dreams and then we'll jump into this.
Oh, okay.
All right.
Is it the app
here? Who has some dreams? We're talking about self-motive. Because there's different kinds of motion. Right? That's his whole theory is based upon different kinds of motion. And he's singling this out as preeminently among the different kinds of motion. This is the one that brings about change, significant change.
Wow.
So the question is, how does that relate to a sieve? Now, most translations of that word use the word essence, and sometimes essentialism, and sometimes another one. There's another one they often translate. In any case, we don't want to do that. We want to see what this word means. And in Proposition 16, he nails it for us, especially the last paragraph. So, Barbara, if you could read it.
Okay. This is, might be an old translation, but I will put Lucia in as Lucia.
Please. Yes.
Can I see any alto?
That's right.
Okay. Proposition 13. All that is converted. Sorry, 16. All that is converted to itself as an ousia separate from all body.
Right. Conversion upon itself. That's a motion.
And you want the body of the proposition?
Yeah, go ahead.
For if ousia were in no way inseparable from the body, it would not have a certain energy separate from body. For if it is impossible for the energy that proceeds from Lucia be separable, for it is impossible for the energy that proceeds from Lucia be separable. If the existence of the body or the being of the body is inseparable from Lucia. Let me try this again. For if Lucia were in no way inseparable from the body, you want to read it?
No, okay. Go ahead.
For if Lucia were in no way inseparable from the body, it would not have a certain energy separate from body. For it is impossible for the energy that proceeds from Lucia to be separable if the existence
body is inseparable from Lucia. For in this way, energy would be superior to Lucia, since the latter would be in more need of bodies, but the former would be self-sufficient. Being dependent on self and not on bodies. If then anything is inseparable according to Lucia, it is also in a similar manner inseparable according to energy. Or rather, it is in a still greater degree inseparable. But if this were the case, it would not be converted to itself. For that which converts to itself...
For that which converts to itself...
Being other than body, has an energy which is separate from body. And not either through body nor together with body.
Look here. If you see it, is this turning upon oneself reflective? That presupposes an energy. That's a kind of motion. Right? And that kind of energy is not connected with any bodily function. Separable from us.
Mm-hmm. Can't be, in fact.
Yeah. Watch the way he concludes. Go ahead.
Since neither the energy nor that to which the energy is directed are in any way in need of the body.
Well, they don't. Doesn't need the body to do this kind of reflective capacity and function. Yeah.
Therefore, that which is converted to itself is altogether separate from bodies.
Right.
So that's 16.
Right.
Proposition 17.
Okay. Anything about that? Okay. Now we want to tie this idea. Right? In other words, this function is separate and distinct from any kind of bodily function. Therefore, the question is, where does this energy come from? And to what is it directed? And how can we understand it? So therefore, he has to go into the next proposition, which is 17. Right?
Okay. All that moves itself primarily is converted it to itself.
Self-motive.
Yes.
He doesn't use that language, but that's what he's talking about.
Yeah. Moving itself primarily.
Right.
All that moves itself primarily is convertive to itself.
Self-motive. Converts to itself. You should say converts to self.
Mm-hmm. Well, this is Aalto, but gotcha. For if it moves itself and its motive energy is directed to itself, that which moves and that which is moved are at the same time one.
Right.
And on the other hand, it is moved in another part of itself. Or the whole moves and is moved. Or, on the one hand, the whole moves, but on the other hand, a part is moved. Or the contrary. But if one distinct part is that which moves, but another part is that which is moved, accordingly it will not be self-motive. For it will consist...
That's in the corporeal world, because you can move other things. Therefore, by laying the foundation, what we're seen right in the elements of
in the theology.
What he's doing is laying the foundation, talking about the different kinds of motion, including self-motion, and he has to then tie that into Rusia, and that becomes the basis for the higher functions of the intellect. Since this is an intellectual function, because really,
yes.
See, this is the intellect turning upon itself, experiencing itself. So that's why we can say, this is really the intellect in its activity, intellecting.
Right.
That which is intelligible.
Is that because reversion is always on the higher, and isn't reversion also all parts reverting upon all parts?
Yes.
I use the word part, but I mean in every
See, the issue then is, where do you get the energy?
That is a good question.
See? Because without the energy, it's not going to function.
Yeah.
Where does Lucia get the energy, or the self-motive? He was asking,
where does Lucia
get the energy?
Did
you hold the self-motive?
What, pardon me?
Are you asking where Lucia gets the energy, where self-motive gets the energy, or both?
Well, at this point, we want to know where the energy comes that is required for the function of turning upon itself, which is really, in my diagram, this constitutes the energy. Where does that come from? Because without that, you're not going to be able to have the turning about and the conversion to the self. So that's where we're going.
Okay.
So we have the faculty, and you need the energy, don't you? And that becomes where we're going.
In the theology?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Fun work.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So which
Let me check.
A is equal to B, and B is equal to
Okay, Saturday?
Oh, yeah, tomorrow, yeah.
At? Regina. Good. Okay, guys, see you then.